Hey folks, today I'm going to do a how-to on washes, how to make your own washes. Now I've already done a video on this a while ago, been a long time ago I think, but since I'm doing a video series on painting and stuff like that and finishing and everything, I figured I'd include this as well, kind of an updated of sorts video. So when it comes to washes, they're very simple, and I'm gonna bang on that drum again about the convenience products again. Making your own washes is far more convenient by any stretch of the imagination than buying them, and it's very simple to explain. You go to the art store and you buy some pastel chalks and some oil paint, water, mineral spirits, and that's it. And you do that once, maybe every 5 or 10 years, and it costs you, I don't know, it depends on how many oil paints you buy, but probably no more than $35-40. That's what it cost me, Canadian. And once every 10 years, I'd say. Probably not even that much. Maybe $30 total. Yeah, including tax. So that's one time. And from that, I've probably made 50, 60 bottles of washes of different types, different colors. So that's one time I've gone to the store. That was the only inconvenience I had. And ever since then, I've been just making them here. And it takes about maybe 2 minutes to make a wash. And I determine what color I need, make it, and it's ready. And I make it in the quantity I need and the color that I need and the consistency that I need right there. I can make it in larger quantities and have it stockpiled for long term, or I can make it in just, if I only need like a tiny bit of one color and I'm not going to be needing it ever again, I only make it. I don't have to waste money on paying for a whole bottle that I'm never going to use again. I'm paying for all the shipping and everything. So again, one time, go to the art store, buy some supplies. And then every time you need washes, you can either make some or you make a bunch of them and put them in your drawer. And you just pull them out and use them when you need to. I got to say, that's super, super convenient. What's inconvenient, at least in my mind, is deciding, okay, I need a wash, a dark brown wash to do panel lines on my armor. So I go online and I shop around for the untold number of dark brown washes that come in all these ridiculous names that are essentially all the same color. They all just have different names, like dark brown for Spazzoli tank number 1 or dark brown for Spazzoli tank number 2. And they're all essentially just dark brown or maybe even almost a black. It makes no difference. They're all panel line washes and they all do the same thing. But you're led to think that you need them all. So you buy 8 different bottles, 5 different bottles, 2 different bottles, whatever. They cost you, I don't know, $9, $14 a bottle, you know, plus shipping and taxes, depending on where you live and where you buy it from. And then you got to wait 2 to 3 days or 2 weeks. For me, it's 2 weeks. And then they show up. And then you decide that you don't need 2 of the 4 bottles that you bought, because they're all the same color, or they're the wrong color. I'm sorry, I could go on. That's ridiculous. It's stupid. Making your own washes is far more sensible than buying that garbage from MIG and ammo, or ammo, MIG, whatever, AK. It's just, there's no argument you could ever possibly make that would make it clear to me that that is a convenience product. So drum beaten, there we go. Anyway, I'm going to show you how to make them. I'll start with the oil wash because that is one that is probably the one you're going to use most often. Oil washes are very simple. You need a little bit of oil paint, a little jar, and a little thinner, and maybe something to mix it with. That's really all you need. You don't need anything else. So For an oil wash, I generally use, for panel lines and stuff like that, for detail, like accent, stuff like that, I use raw umber. That's usually the color that I go with. Sometimes I will add lamp black to it, depending on how dark I want. For sci-fi and stuff like that, I usually just go with all black, but it doesn't make any difference what your purposes are. I'll use this just for now. So for panel lines, details, and stuff like that, that kind of a wash, which is what I'm making right now, I use a blob of paint about the size of a chickpea. So if you know what a chickpea looks like, that's the size of paint ball that I go with. So I will get it started here. Usually about that much. Now I bought this tube of paint 2006 is when I bought that. It's almost done. And it cost me about maybe $7 for that. That's how long that's lasted. And there's still another 3 or 4 years worth in there. I try to get that ball of paint down in there. Threads. Then the rest of the effort is spent in adding thinner. This is mineral spirits. I add it right up to the bottom of the shoulder there. So this is a 2 ounce. I think it's a 2 ounce jar, I believe. 4 ounce jar. Sorry, it's a 4 ounce jar. I have all kinds of these. I bought them on eBay 15 years ago, I think. And I just keep reusing them. I have a couple of different types. That's another one there. I have some fat ones like this. Right. I also have a bunch of these. I bought these on Amazon. I use these for clays and stuff like that, but I'll talk about that in a bit too. So anyway, so I put the cap on, and then I shake it by hand first. You can do the same thing. Instead of using mineral spirits, you can use terpenoid, odorless thinner. I try, when I'm making washes, I try to use mineral spirits only because it expands the shelf life. The stuff does have a shelf life. It doesn't matter if you buy the over-the-counter stuff, like the big stuff or the AK stuff, or you make your own. It will only last so long. Eventually the paint will start to dry, even though it's in thinner, and you'll start getting little flakes floating in it. There's no way to avoid that. It's just the nature of it. Right, so once I shake it up a little bit, I will take a little Acme painter. These things are for making cappuccino and shit, but they also are good for stirring paint. And they cost about $5 or $6. A little battery operated mixer. Now, one last thing to do. You got to label it. Very important. Otherwise, you'll never remember what the fuck it is. Find a pen. Knock the camera out of position too. That's always helpful. There we go. I always write down the paint and the thinner. Mineral spirits. If I had used odorless terpenoid or water or whatever, that's also what I would is also what I would have written on there. See on there, lamp black. You can't even read that. Lamp black oil terpenoid. This is raw umber. I forgot to write oil. So, and that's it. That's an oil wash. Ta-da. Now, the difference between an oil wash and an enamel wash is very small. What you just saw me do is exactly the same. The only difference is adding the thinner and the paint is a little bit trickier. Generally, if I was making an enamel wash, I would have poured the thinner into the bottle the same way, but I would have added the paint differently because enamel paint is already pre-liquefied. It's not like a blob of paint like this. It's already liquid. So I would add it with a pipette. If you don't know what a pipette is, I have some right here. This is a pipette or pipette. It's graduated, has little lines on here. So when you pick up the paint from your enamel paint bottle, you can gently release it until the paint comes up to the same amount every time. Instead of measuring out a chickpea-sized blob of paint, you measure out exactly the same amount of paint every time on here. In fact, it's possible to get more accurate reproduction for your enamel washes because you're using a graduated pipette. And then you pick it up and then put it into your bottle with your thinner. And then you mix it up. And then you're done. It's as simple as that. That is how you do an oil wash. It's very simple. There's enough wash in that bottle for me to do probably 70, 80 models at least, and possibly a couple of dioramas, right? Buildings and stuff like that. So there's a lot in there. So now I will probably go through this pretty quickly because I tend to use it a lot. I was almost out of my other bottle, and that was probably a couple of years old. So, a clay-based wash, which is what I'm going to talk about next, is a little bit more involved. And clay-based washes are useful for a lot of different reasons. Oil washes are good because they just bring out detail and stuff like that. And if you thin them out super, super thin, you create what are called varnishes or glazes or filters. These are things you can do if you just add tiny, tiny amounts of paint to your thinner. So it's essentially the same sort of thing, and you can make those in large quantities like this as well. I have some here somewhere. Here's a gray filter. This is a gray filter. Now it's been lying on its side, so it's hard to show you. There's a very tiny amount of paint in here, but if I mix it up, right, it just goes gray. But the amount of paint that's in here is actually quite small in comparison to the amount of paint that I put in here. The amount of paint that I would put here would be about maybe 3 grains of rice, basmati rice. Be about the size of the amount of paint in here. I've effectively created tinted thinner is what it, that's the difference. This is nearly paint. This is tinted thinner. So there's a big difference between these two things. So, but they're both technically a wash of type. A clay-based wash has a few more uses than a oil-based wash because a clay-based wash can add texture as well because it has larger particulates because it's made out of pastel chalks. So it can also do panel lines and recessed and raised details like an oil wash can, but it can also add dirt effects depending on what stage of your painting you're working on. If it's Post-gloss, if you just put your gloss coat on and you finished all your detailing and you did your decals and all that, and you just sealed the whole tank and you're going to do your wash phase, or that's where you're going to be doing your detailing, where you're bringing out the details like the raised and recessed details. You're at that stage and you decide you're going to use clay to do it. You can. Absolutely you can. If you just mix it up really, really dark, so lots of black, maybe a tiny bit of brown, which I'm going to do here. I'm actually going to make a wash for doing that kind of thing. And you use that instead of an oil. Now, the difference between the two is the clay one will tend to look a lot like dirt and accumulated grime rather than shadow. But if it's dark enough, it will do both. So it's an unusual thing, and it's a personal taste thing, which one you want to use. There's also certain situations where you would want to use it, like around fuel doors, like fuel ports and stuff, where dirt and grease get mixed together and you get that dirty, greasy sort of effect and everything, where a clay-based wash is really good at affecting that, especially if you get a kind of glossy look to it and everything. So it's really easy to do that with a clay-based wash. You couldn't do that with an oil-based wash. It doesn't look quite the same. You'd still have to add some kind of pigment to it in order to get that built up greasy grime sort of thing. So, but anyway, the uses of a clay-based wash are, I'm still discovering them. Because there's so many of them. I don't know, there's some black. I need that. So to make a clay-based wash, you need pastel chalks. Don't have any dark brown in that one. I need black. I have dark brown. Oh yeah. Got a dark brown. Now, this is a very simple process. Now, the really cool thing about making a clay-based wash is you can do two things at the same time. You can make the ingredients for your clay-based wash and make the ingredients for a pigment that you can apply to your vehicle later. It's a wonderful thing because the same material is used to do both. It's a great thing. So that's why I get this little jar. So to make a clay-based wash, like I said, you need pastel chalks. You need a hobby knife. You don't need that. You need like a piece of paper towel to work on because it's quite messy. Some kind of jar to collect it in, and a mortar and pestle. Actually, I don't know which one's the mortar and which one's the pestle. Mortar and pestle. Mine's made of marble. And I chose marble for the reason because it's super, super smooth, but it has a little tiny bit of grit at the bottom, which helps me break up the, by grit, I mean it's not super smooth at the bottom. It helps me break up the larger pieces that I create. So we have black. So the first thing I want, oh yeah, you also need a jar to put your wash in and water and last thing. A little tiny bit of glycerol or glycerin. That's all you need. All of this costs about maybe $2. But once you buy the tools, if you already have one of these, or your wife is donating one to you, or your girlfriend or whatever, your mom, you know, you get that. But this, I think I bought this for about $8 on Amazon a couple of years ago. I did have another one, but I accidentally dropped it on the floor and it went boom, poofy, poofy. And that one I think I spent about $10 on. It was a nicer one. It was bigger. So, yeah, water, oh, it's free. The glycerol, it was like $4.99 at the drugstore or apothecary or chemist, depending on what you wanted to call it. These, I bought these on Amazon a few years ago. They came in a 12-pack. It was like for $6 or $7, and I've only had to buy two of them. I have a bunch of other ones because I used to use over-the-counter clay-based wash from Ultimate Modeling Products. I don't know if they make them anymore. So I keep the jars because they're useful. They're a good-sized jar. I used to also have some flurry washes, which I didn't really care much for, so I stopped using those. The Ultimate washes were actually pretty good. But again, like I said, I don't have any more of them, so I don't I make my own. So, and I bought this at the grocery store, and I think it was like $2 for a pack of 20 for these. They're for salad dressing, but they're also good for holding pigments. So, this, I don't know where this came from. I use this for holding, I found a pack of them in my closet. I can't remember where I got it from. But I use this for using like small amounts for like oil washes and stuff like that. If I'm just going to be needing a small amount of a color, I use the smaller bottles. So anyway, off topic. So anyway, the first thing I need to do is start creating the pigment. And I usually do it in a jar like this. And hopefully you'll be able to see. I'm going to move you a little closer. Sorry about the wobbly camera. So you take your hobby knife and you start scraping. Now you generally only have to do this maybe once or twice every couple of years. For me, I have to do it more often because I build quite frequently. But, you know, you put on a movie or a TV show or something, this just becomes monotony. I do it this way, where I scrape it off into a dust because it speeds up the grinding process. If I just took a piece of this off and put it right in the mortar and pestle, it's a lot of work to grind that up. I found, even though this is boring as fuck, it makes my life easier. And I waste less pastel. I mean, pastel's not free. It's not, they're not overly expensive, but they're not free. I tried using a coffee grinder, one that you use to grind up beans, but they make the bits. It doesn't grind it up small enough, and it fucks up the coffee grinder after a while. It stops working. The dust clogs it up, and then just goes, oh, that didn't work so well. In the end, this is the way I ended up choosing to do it, because the amounts that I need are not commercial level. So I don't need to go crazy. All right, that's enough for one bottle. Let's see if I can show you how much is in there. It's very hard to see, I guess. Oh, there you go. It's a rough idea. That's how much is in there. All right, I'm gonna add about the same amount, but maybe half as much of the brown. Because this brown is actually, it looks dark, but it's actually lighter than you think. As you can see by where I scrape it off, that's actually the color of it there. It just develops, it oxidizes. And I grind the shit out of it. This is easier than it looks. It should look like a paste. If you've done it enough, it'll look like a paste. Contrast might not be good enough that you can actually see it, But it actually looks like a paste. But if you hit it, it goes back to a powder, right? And that's what you want. So now I need to get it off. Where's my brush? Brush that I do this with. I have this brush that I use to scrape off the pastel once it gets stuck to the side. Then I put it back into this. Now, add this to the bottle. If you want to get fancy, you can use a funnel. And then I usually add a drop of glycerol. Glycerol is dish soap, but don't use dish soap. Use glycerol. It's pure. Dish soap isn't. In a pinch, you can use it, but I find dish soap foams up too much. And then the rest is water. This is water that I get out of my reverse osmosis system. So it's doesn't have any contaminants in it. There's none that I know of. Now the purpose of the glycerol is to break the surface tension. So it's called the meniscus, the surface layer. It's like a rubbery skin over the surface of liquids. And when you add glycerol to it, it breaks it up so it's thinner, and you can mix a powder to the water nice and easily. And then you can add that to a surface of something nice and easily. If you find that it's not mixing very well, you need to add more glycerin. Let me put the cover on and shake the bejesus out of it. I have a machine that I can do that with, but I didn't want to turn it on because it's really loud. That looks mixed. If you see bubbles, bloop, 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 it means it's not mixed. All right. Let's that's the stuff right there. Ta-da. And it works. And that is a clay wash. There's enough clay wash in there. Oh my God. That'll last me for probably a couple of hundred models, 100 or 200. I'd say maybe, let's say 100, nice and, yeah, to be fair, about 100 models. If I do dioramas with it, a lot less because I go crazy with it on the dioramas. So, yeah, about 100 vehicles I could do with this one bottle. So, yeah. Hey, Murph. Here comes Murphy. Murph. Say hi, buddy. Behind the microphone. I know, it's so gripping, eh? That's his opinion of me every time he sees me. Big yawn. All right, so I gotta label it. I have a fancy label maker, but this is faster. I don't have to charge up tape. I don't have to change the cartridge in tape. wash clay. Don't need anything more specific like European Earth World War II Sunday at Bob's camp last April in a barbecue. I don't need specific name types like that. It's just foolish doing that. There's no way to know exactly what those colors were anyway. Okay, so that is a clay wash and an oil wash, and I've explained briefly how to do an enamel wash. It's essentially the same as the oil wash. I guess that's about it for that. For making pigments, it's exactly the same as what you just saw me doing there, only you don't put it in a jar with full of water. Leave out the water. Leave out the glycerin. That's all. The pastel chalks work just fine for making pigments. Now, you can use watercolor pencils as well to do work with like a clay wash, very similarly. I do not recommend those AK weathering pencils because they're watercolor pencils. They're very expensive watercolor pencils, but they're the same. I had a couple here, and I compared them to the watercolor pencils that I've been using for the last 25 years, and they're the same. They only come in a few colors, though, and they come in twice the price. So, I don't recommend those. That's a bit of it's a gimmick, and it's a cash grab by AK, and shame on them. The watercolor pencils you can get on Amazon, good quality ones, right? Like, spend $20 on the box, and you get, like, 30 colors. And believe it or not, you'll find uses for most of those colors, especially if you do aircraft. The AK ones, it's just, wow. It's as bad as MIG and his brass toothpick, AK's watercolor pencils. What a gimmick. Holy cow. That is such obvious trying to take advantage of modelers and their inexperience. That's what that is. Or MIG's oil brushers. Oh my God. Wow. It's like, dude, it's such a scam. It's such a terrible scam. I see that stuff and it makes me so mad when I see it. I'm like, oh my God, really? Why don't you just wear a shirt that says thief? Might as well. It's terrible. Anyway, so that's clay wash. That's oil wash. And you can add that together to make the enamel wash, like I told you. Pretty simple. So, yeah, so about $30 and you're set for 20 years. Something like that. I think that's all I got. Yeah, that's all I got. You guys be good. Keep your stick on the ice. Bye for now.